Hey everyone, I'm Nog, and welcome back to Factorio. We are starting to near our power consumption, so we are getting close to using all of the power we're producing. Not right now, but that's because some machines are, or some production lines are backed up. But when they're not, we are getting up to around our max. So we are going to set up some more power today. And I have handcrafted a bit so that we have enough to set up an entire other line of steam power. So that is what we're going to do. And after that, we are going to go look at getting our advanced oil processing going, because that is going to be very important for us. So this will only take a short while, and then we will do the advanced oil processing. Now I'm not putting these directly across from the others, because sometimes they fight a bit over who gets the coal if you do that. So instead I am spacing them out a little bit. Then we need some pipe. Did I make pipe? Yes, I did. Get some pipe in here. There. And actually, one thing I did forget to make was a water pump. That we can do. So let's get an offshore pump in here. Like so. And let's go underground to over there. And like that. Alright. So those are up. Then we need some boilers or some steam engines. They are going in nice and fast. Sometimes one didn't. So try that again. All right. Almost there. Keep standing in the way. And there we go. Then we just need some power poles. We can get here. Let's actually use the small ones that we have. We're not gonna need those anymore. And there we go. We are now producing way more power. We have doubled our power output. We also need to do some research, and what I would like to research today is advanced oil processing. I actually thought I had researched that already. Darn it. Let's get that researched as fast as possible so that we can get the advanced oil processing setup going. All right, our iron patch over here and our copper patch over here are pretty much dead now, so we can clean them up a little bit while we wait for the advanced oil processing to complete. Pretty much all of them are empty, and that leaves us a lot of space for future train stations, which is good. I did not want to remove that one. That one actually still had some ore. Alright. We can tear all of these poles down. Tear this down. So this is nice. We're getting some cleanup done while we get the advanced oil processing done. So that's not a bad thing. Alright, and what we can just do is like so. And we've cleaned that one out. And there's actually some ore right there. So let's get that. Might as well, right? And then we can tear this one out. so, and we can do the same here. There, and this can get torn out. And these guys can get torn out. And we need these power poles. Don't really need that one. We don't need this. And we can just do like that for now. There we go. So almost done. And let's clean this up as well. This is also basically all dead. These guys, tear out these poles. These guys are all dead. Tear out that pole. This guy is dead. All right. This guy is dead too. We can tear out this entire line. There. Stick this in here so that it can get out. Let's see, what can we tear down? We can tear that down. Tear that down. I think that is it. We can tear this one down as well. Alright. So, all of these are basically done. I suppose we can tear these two down as well. There. Oops. There we go. And we can tear out these turrets. Don't need them here anymore. All right. So all of that is cleaned up a bit. The coal here won't last that long either. We can actually... This is done, this is done, this is done. Anything else that's done? Yes. There's the advanced oil processing. So now we can get started on that. Which is good. Tear this out. Oh, I guess we can't tear that out. Just yet. Those two we can. Alright. Good, good, good. And... let's see. Input priority left. Actually, that's not true. We want out priority left. Yeah. I think that's what we want. All right. Good. So we have the advanced oil processing, which means that we can go down here and start working on this stuff. And let's see. Let's just... tear out these just for now. And let's see. So we have here, we want to set the recipe to advanced. And we need an oil pump or a water pump for this stuff. We can just put that down there. And then we need to get water over here. And we can just actually, oh darn it. Okay, whoops. Messing everything up now. Alright, so we need to set this recipe for all of them. There we go. And then we actually need to come one down for the water. So let's just turn this out. And oops, get the offshore pump in there again. And it needs to be here, I guess. Yes. And like so, and then we need to come over like this, and that is going to be in the way. There, all done. And then we just need the regular pipes. There we go. And like so. And I guess that the pole I had in there somewhere was not needed at all, so that's fine. But okay, so we have the advanced oil processing going, and now we need to do some cracking. So we need to get some of these guys going, and I think we'll set it up down here. So we have one, and let's just leave a little bit of space, and then we have seven, like so. And we will set this to crack heavy oil to light oil, and then we will set these to crack light oil to petroleum gas, like so. And then we just need to get the stuff up there. So let's see, this is heavy oil, go in there, and they all need water as well, so they can't actually be like this. Let's just change that. There, give a bit of space, and then like so. 5, 6, 7, and get this cracking going. And I would have liked to line it up more nicely. Did we do that? Yes, we should. So this will come from here to here, and we'll set these up, and just to be sure, that's the right side. All right, good, good. So, oops, where was that? 5, 6, 7, and like so. Wonder if we don't have enough pipe. I need to go pick up some pipe. I do not want to handcraft it. So this goes here. So, and this goes here. And over a water pump somewhere. I guess right around here. But we also need to get this water into this guy. Well, I guess we will do like that. And tear these out and do that again. So something like this. Let's just make the offshore pump and get that in. There we go. And then we need power for them, of course. We'll put that down here. And then we need some lights, so we can see what they're doing, like that. And we need some more pipe. Let's just go pick that up real quick. And also, let's get some more research going. Do we want to do? Let's do. Could do some of the uranium stuff. Or actually, let's do this, because I think I want to use electric mining drills or mining furnaces. What are they called? Not mining furnaces, just electric furnaces, I guess. Yeah. Here we go. Here we have the pipes. And do we need, yeah, we need more underground as well. Alright. So let's go and get this setup finalized so that we can start making batteries and all of the good stuff and get robotics going so that we can get our small friends to do all the work for us. That is always a good thing. Like so. Okay. So there we go. And are they going? Yes, they are. Fantastic. And this one needs to come out. And let's just pull it out to the middle. And then go down here. And I don't want to block myself off. Like so. So that's done. And then we need these guys output. And we just need it on one side. So let's just put it on this side. And we need to get it into the tanks. And this one actually goes to this one down here. So let's just make that turn right here so we don't interfere. All right, we'll just do like that. There we go. So we have that going, and then we need heavy and light oil. There we go. That should do it. We have all of this going. This isn't full. This is almost full, and this is staying steady, sort of. So yeah, we have production again of plastics. Very nice. And a lot of plastic production right now. It's good. And we'll probably need more at some point. But then we'll fix it. Okay, so very happy about that. And the next thing is getting some sulfur production going, I think. So we have two of these guys. Let's see, how much space do we have? We have plenty of space over here, so let's go over here, or should we go over the other way? Because we have all of the production over here. I think we'll go down here and set them up here. So let's see, we want to make sulfur, which takes water and petroleum gas. And then we now want to make sulfuric acid, which takes iron plate, sulfur, and water. Okay. So, whoops, that's not what I wanted to make in this one. I wanted to make that. All right. So we need an output here. And like so. There we go. And then we need an input of water, which we can also get relatively easily. Ooh, this is perfect. We'll, I don't actually know if it needs its own water pump, but it's gonna get one. So let's stick that in there. Like so. Right? Very good. And it needs some power. And I still haven't gotten around to setting up power pole production automated, which I really should. And we need an output. And just be here. I think we only need one of these, maybe two. let's see. This produces. Where's the last one there? Did we set up two, just in case? So it produces 2 sulfur every second. If we do this, then it produces 50 sulfuric acid every second with 5 sulfur. So we need more. We need 2 more, actually. So let's see, can we make some of these? Oh, yes. So let's just make sure that we got the ratios right. We don't have to come back and redo everything. And there, I guess. And let's stick another one in. There, there. There. And there. And there we go. And we need another power pole. And some output. What I think I will do is, let's see, we could get the iron coming in on the other side, the iron plate, so that they're sharing the belt. I think that would probably be okay. Yeah, why not? We need to rotate it though, like that. Yes. And not necessarily. No, this is fine. And we'll get this going over here. And then we need an input of iron here somewhere. Let's see, we need water. I think we can just use the same water as we were using for the other stuff. So we'll do like this. There you have water. You have power, light, and you need an input of sulfur and of iron, which will be on the other side of the belt. I think we will do double so that it has 2. And then you need an output of sulfuric acid, and it needs to go into a tank. We will not stick in here because it'll be in the way. So let's see, how far can this go? It can go all the way up here. And then we can just turn a little bit. Come out here. And that's where we'll have our tank for our sulfuric acid. All right. And now we just need the iron. Which we can get from up here. We need a splitter or something like that. And then we need to go underground here. So this will be going a little bit in the wrong direction. Something weird happened there, didn't it? Yeah. So this should go like that. Something weird is going on. Something very, very weird. I know. So like this. There we go. Much better. And four. Four. And I think this is the last one, right? Yeah. And then we can just pull it along. Go under again. Go under again. This is a little bit ridiculous, but okay. Never mind. Alright. And come under again. And turn in there. Alright, so that should give us sulfuric acid. Yes, indeedy. Outstanding. So we have sulfuric acid coming in. And next is going to be batteries. For which we need iron plate, copper plate, and sulfuric acid. So I think we'll pull the sulfuric acid up and run on our main bus and build our battery production up there. But that will be in the next episode. We are out of time, guys. So thank you very much for watching. I think we made some decent progress, a lot more power. Advanced oil processing setup is done. Sulfuric acid is done. All the oil cracking is done. So yeah, I think we're doing pretty well. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, why not leave a like and maybe subscribe? And I will see you next time.